Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator 2022. And we're going to be using the Washington to Baltimore route, and the train we are going to be in control of today, folks, will be the Amtrak Acela Express. Likewise, I'm just going to go through the briefing, and then we're going to get started on this third Let's Play to come of February 2022. So I'm just going to release the doors, as I've just done there, and I'm going to show you the train from external view, set up the headlights and stuff, and do the thumbnail before we get too far into this, okay? Change of plan, folks. I'm going to wait until we're out of the terminal station, okay? As therefore, I will be able to see what I'm doing. And we will see the train better once we're out in the open air, okay? So, just waiting for the passengers to board and stuff. Just to let you know, folks, this is a career mode scenario. And I do have the scores turned off. So, if the settings are correct, I will receive no points at all. So I'm just going to wait our turn here until we get the road. And then we can get started on this first scenario for this route. Now that we've done the thumbnail for this video, I will stay in the cab until the end, and we're just coming out of Washington, I believe. But anyways, we're still in the 15 miles an hour restricted zone, so I'm just being mindful of the speed limit and of course the signals up ahead as well. Although it doesn't really matter too much because I do have the career mode scores disabled, as to be honest, I like to have realism as much as I possibly can. And likewise, I'm just using the power just so we do not go too fast, but we should be able to increase speed very soon once we enter the 45 miles an hour zone. Another thing as well, folks, I do have a neutral to a like for the Acela Express, as that was another train that I first started off with in Microsoft Train Simulator back in 2002. So it is nice to drive what I'd call an old classic, or at least in my opinion anyways. Although it's definitely got a different cab to what the original Microsoft Train Simulator version had. And I think this is my first time I've used the Northeast Corridor route. But I may cover that in many more future Let's Plays to come on this channel between now and in the future. Well, folks, I have to say, this does bring back memories and reminiscing on the old Microsoft Train Simulator route. There was the Northeast Corridor, and it does look very much like an enhanced version of that, in my opinion. Although, to be honest, this is the very first time I've actually done a Let's Play on the Northeast Corridor. And I do have the Acela HHP-8 electric locomotive as well, of which does come with its own Amfleet cards, of which I did use those for my Let's Play on the Civic Surfliner with that P42DC locomotive. But this video will be much shorter, as this scenario is only about 35 minutes long, so it won't be as long as the other one was. And I will be covering the ACS-64 and some other US trains for this week of February anyways. As to be honest with you folks, I have decided to shake up this month a bit. As you know, I did all of January's Let's Plays mostly on the UK, so I've decided to go like this. The first week of February will be the US trains, then the second week of February will be Germany, and then the third week of February will be another European route, and then the fourth week of February will be some UK trains and routes again. But it will be shaken up a bit different, as I will be using different routes and trains just to shake up the schedule a bit, you know. As you know, I'm striving to improve my channel, and at least at the time this video is made, I'm not too far away from 9,000 subscribers. So I'm really, really pleased with what and how my channel is improving and it's growing. And as always, please do feel free to leave your feedback. You can use the channel email address, which is in the video description, if you want to contact me privately, or just leave me a comment in the comment section below. I do read your comments, and I do reply to them once I'm aware of them. As you know, I don't forget where I come from, and I don't forget those of you that enjoy my content, as I do listen to suggestions and stuff. So that's my take on it anyways. But I'm really, really pleased with how my channel is going so far, and it's really great. I'm not too far away now from 9,000 subscribers, and it would be great if I could get 10,000 subscribers this year of 2022. So feel free to share my videos, folks, if you want to, okay, as it will help, and I'd greatly appreciate it, please. Well, folks, we're just coming into our first station stop, I believe, on this route. I think it could be an intermediate one. I'm not entirely sure, as I've not played the train simulator version of the Northeast Corridor. And I can't remember the original Microsoft Train Simulator version of this route in full detail, so I'm just braking early just so that I do not overrun the station. Okay, but our first intermediate stop will be BWI Airport Track 1, at least for this service. So I'm just going to coast into the station. I know I've braked a wee bit too early on this occasion, but I'd rather brake early than brake late and overrun the platform. Okay then, this is our first intermediate station stop, and I have released the doors to allow the passengers to board and alight the train. Okay then, our next stop will be Baltimore Penn Track number 6, and that is about just over 10.5 miles away. Without further ado, let's continue on to our next station stop for this scenario. And we do have a caution signal, folks, so I may have to take action and be prepared to stop if need be, just to avoid any game over errors. Right, folks, I'm going to start slowing down as we do have a danger signal up ahead, and I definitely do not want to fail the mission. So I'm going to start slowing down, folks, okay? So we'll see what the signal up ahead has in store for us. So as long as I'm going slow enough to take appropriate action, and whatever reason, the notifications about the ATC and the signaling system keep saying disabled, so there is track workers on the line somewhere, but I will sound my horn and turn on the bell if I spot any track workers nearby, just to let them know of my presence, just like I would in the real world. But likewise, folks, I'm just driving on the side of caution until I can get a visual on the signal up ahead. Okay then, the signal is clearly at danger, so we cannot proceed any further until the line up ahead is open again. And to be honest, I'm definitely not used to these kind of signals, and I do remember back in the days of Microsoft Train Simulator when I was first starting out in train sim stuff, that I didn't really pay attention to the signals, and I accidentally ran past one of these red signals like this, and it said activity ended, ignored red light. For those of you who may remember, this wrote on Microsoft Train Simulator. But nonetheless, career mode is very much the same. If you do pass one of these red signals, it will end the scenario, as we're on normal, what I call the normal mode, it does not. But nonetheless, we'll just hold position here until the line ahead clears. Okay. Additionally, very nice to see some different NPC trains driving about as we are heading towards Baltimore. I believe the diesel could be an MP36PH, although I'm not entirely sure what the railroad operator would be that uses that locomotive, but I'm assuming for copyright reasons it is intentionally left debranded for this route. But I'm not sure if it's player drivable or just NPC only, but I do have the Caltrain version, the California one, of which I did cover quite a long time ago now, and I may cover that route again. It's the one that goes to San Francisco. I can't remember the route from the top of my head, folks, okay? But I do have the route and the train still, so I will cover that in another Let's Play in the future, as it's been a long time since I have used that route, to be honest with you. Hopefully, we shouldn't have to wait here too long. Once the line ahead is clear, we should be able to go. But fingers crossed, not too long left to wait now. Okay then, I've just asked for permission and I have been granted permission to pass the signal, so I'm going to continue onwards at a reduced speed of 20 miles an hour, so I'm going to try not to go too heavy on the power and just increase our speed slowly, just enough to bring us up to the next signal. Right, folks, we're just coming into Baltimore Penn Track 6. I'm not sure if the scenario will end here or if there is another station stop. However, due to the confusion with that red signal, of which in the end I had to tab past it, we are about 8 minutes late. Well, correction, 10 minutes late. So this Let's Play is a bit longer than what it was meant to be. But if you watched it all the way through to the end, folks, I just want to say to you a big thank you for staying with me. Okay? And as always, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best. And God bless. And I will catch you in another Let's Play to come very soon on this channel. Okay? I do hope you have enjoyed this one. And please, as always, do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I do listen to your feedback, both positive and constructive, as it does help with my channel, you know. But anyways, that's all for now, folks. I'm going to stop the train here and drop off the passengers. And I think this could be the end of the Let's Play. I have no idea. But this is a two-part scenario. But I'm only going to do this one. That's all for now, folks. I will see you in the next Let's Play.